Alright, here we are for round one. We're going to be on the draw with, unfortunately, a pretty bad hand, so I think we'll take a mulligan. Yeah, this one's okay. It's not great, but it'll work. Definitely do not need that to start off. We have plenty of lands. We're looking for, like, a knight or maybe a Dromoka's Command. Probably not a Dromoka's Command. A Silk Wrap, maybe. There you go. Ask and you shall receive. I'm going to lead with, I guess, with Canopy Vista. Basically, you want to have double white when you're, especially when you're on the draw. Like, if our opponent plays a Jace this turn, we're going to want to Silk Wrap it and have white-white available. So if we draw a knight, we can play it and get value. So you should plan to be getting a Plains as your second land, usually. Yeah, things are going exactly as I anticipated. Ooh. Well, now I'm going to play Hanger Back instead of playing Silk Wrap. I'm fine giving him one loot off the Jace, and I would actually be more scared of Mantis Rider right now because we have no effective way to deal with it. So I think letting him get one loot is fine to get Hanger Back on board, and then that means we can charge it up next turn. Curves out a little better. And like I said, we might have to let him flip his Jace here, as much as I would prefer not to. Also, now if we draw Dromoka's Command, we can use that to kill Jace and then Silk Wrap to kill Mantis Rider. There's just a lot of advantages to getting the Hanger Back on the board first. Ding, ding, ding. There we go. So, let's see. We could kill Mantis Rider and make 3/1s, but that gives him, I think, too good of a chance to actually flip his Jace. So I'm just going to kill his Jace now and guess play basic forest. And I guess we might as well charge now also. Plays around a shock of some kind. There are some upsides to having 3/1 flyers. It's pretty hard for Jeskai to deal with like a bunch of small dudes. But I think, yeah, I think it's just more important that we not die and that we get the Jace off the board. So, he just left up a bunch of mana, which makes me think Ojutai's Command, probably, which will get back his Jace, which is not a huge deal. We have to decide if we want to attack with... Basically, I'm definitely casting Silk Wrap this turn, and the thing to decide is whether to attack with Hanger Back or whether to level it up. And I think leveling it up is going to be better. It lets us pressure his Jace a lot more. Because I assume, what's going to happen here is we're going to Silk Wrap his Mantis Rider. He's going to Ojutai's Command back his Jace and draw a card and then flip it on his turn. So I would rather get as much pressure on Jace as possible. Also, drawing the second forest was pretty bad. There's only three in the deck, and sometimes you run out of ones to search for Nissa. So that's kind of unfortunate. Ah, looks like it was Dig Through Time instead. Well, now I'm going to charge Hanger Back right now. That's a little worse for us, I think. I think I would prefer for him to have a flip Jace rather than a double tutor. But that's okay. We're still certainly in okay shape. Sometimes these Jeskai decks also just have trouble dealing with a Hanger Back. And we can rebuy our Dromoka's Command, so we have a way to deal with Mantis Rider, even though we will take quite a beating from it if he has one. Yep. As expected. Yavimaya Coast. Alright, that's not doing us a lot of good. So we're going to be at 6. It's pretty precarious, but it's definitely still winnable. And the basic swamp is kind of a giveaway that he's probably on the Pantheon's Jeskai list, which is something to note. for sure. Very relevant. Yep, we'll take our Mantis Rider down to 6. Just have to avoid getting raced here. So we're going to rebuy Dromoka's command end of turn. Gideon. All right, that ain't bad. I guess we just go ahead and play Gideon here. And yeah, I think I just mostly wanted to see if it would resolve if he has negate or something. Yeah, I probably just want to make a 2/2. Yeah, that's fine. Could emblem, but there's not much point. We're going to have our hanger back fight his Mantis Rider anyway. I think during his upkeep is probably the best time to do that. And we're getting in for 7 damage here, so, you know, our clock is pretty fast at this point. We also have a Nissa that's going to flip next turn. So things are looking okay as long as we manage to not die. So something like Utter End would be really a disaster here. But if it's just... Dispel's pretty bad for us also. Still needs probably 2 burn spells. There's not a lot of 3 damage burn in the format. And he's going after Gideon, so that's really good for... Well, never mind. Changed his mind. I'd be really happy if he was attacking Gideon. I think that would... Me and we were pretty likely to win. Soulfire. Okay. That is not bad. So I think we start off with Nissa and flip it and plus and see what we get off that. And then we'll proceed from there. Wingmate. 1 mana short. So we're probably dead here. Is there any way we can force him to chump with Mantis Rider this turn? If we emblem, then he can just chump block the hanger back and take 7 from our creatures, and that doesn't kill him. If we plus Gideon, he chumps the hanger back, chumps Knight Ally, or chumps Gideon here. And takes 5 and doesn't die. I think plussing is our best line. It's very unlikely that we don't lose this game. Needed to hit something with our Nissa or have him not have dispel. Although I think it needed to be either dispel or utter end for us to not win. Because if it was just like crackling doom to kill off our hanger back. Oh, he has crackling doom now. It's too bad we can't sacrifice our own Gideon. Yeah, we're just dead. Close game, though. Very close. I think if we were on the play, also, we might have won that game. So, for sideboarding in this matchup, when I'm on the play, I do not really like Knight of the White Orchid. Valorous Stance is... Actually, it's okay if I think they're on the Pantheon version of the deck, which it looked very strongly like our opponent was, just because they had... The basic Swamp is kind of a giveaway. So, I'm going to leave in Valorous Stance. Silk Wrap is clearly great. Surge of Righteousness I like as a one of usually. It's not amazing, but it's not awful either. I don't like Disdainful Stroke. I've actually liked Mastery as a one of as well. I don't think you want more than one of this. Like, it's not really a game plan, but there are definitely the grindy games where the card's very effective. And then the last card, I think I usually go with a Stratus Dancer. And again, this sideboarding definitely changes depending on what we see from them and you know what we expect. So this is what I'm going to go with for now. All right, here we are for game 2. We get to go first this time. Ooh, and we have a pretty nice little curve. Definitely a keeper. could run headfirst into Radiant Flames here, but we do have Den Protector to rebuy our Death Mist anyway, so that's fine. For that reason, I'm probably going to level up Warden. Maybe not into a... Well, he's just killing it now anyway, I assume. I wish these foils looked better. This just doesn't look good at all. It just looks like a funny shaded mountain. It's a nice looking mountain, but it just looks stupid. So we'll fetch up our planes and cast a hangar back. No Jace from our opponent, which means we're definitely going to... Well, I was going to say we're definitely going to Death Mist. I think we are still going to Death Mist Raptor here. The Hangerback is a little more flexible and lets us spend our mana perhaps more efficiently later down the road if there's a turn where we, you know, where we want to cast it for two or something. So I would rather save it for that reason. Basically, I just want to spend all my mana this turn. So the other option would have been to play the hangar back and level up this one. Neither is particularly horrible against Radiant Flames, because, like, you know, if this dies, who cares? And this I can get back with the Den Protector later. Okay. There's a Mantis Rider to Silkwrap. But, for example, now if we draw a land, we'll be able to cast Silkwrap plus another 1-point hangar back on our turn. Which I think is setting us up, you know, setting us up to deal more damage and use our mana more efficiently. So overall, I feel good about that decision. Another Mantis Rider? Come on, man. This is starting to get a little nasty. Well, that's not bad. So now I think I'm just gonna have the counter go on Death Mist and fight that and hit him for four and level up both my hangar backs. The other option is to level a hangar back and then put a counter on it and have it fight the Mantis Rider and get 3/1/1s out of the deal, which I think is a little worse. I think this plays around a potential sweeper better, which I think is the main way our opponent will get back into the board here. It also hits for slightly more damage this turn, which is not a huge concern, but is not nothing either. All right, that was good. Nice little curve there. So, on the draw, my sideboarding changes pretty substantially. The knights come back in, because they're great when you're on the draw. Warden, I think, is pretty bad. I maybe should board it out when I'm on the play, too. I'm not actually sure. Kind of awkward, we still haven't seen a Valorous Stance target. I think one is probably still fine. Probably find a use for it. I'm going to board out the Stratus Dancer just to make room for the knights. And I kind of want to cut a Dromoka's Command. It's a lot better when you're on the play. It's still pretty good. I could also see cutting Wingmate Rock because Ojutai's Command on it is such a beating. So that's sort of the other option. Maybe I'll do that, yeah. The only question is I kind of am considering bringing in one more Surge of Righteousness. Nah, I think this is fine. I think this looks like a good plan. Alright, here we are for game three. We are on the draw with a mediocre hand. I think I am going to keep. Removal spell into Gideon is pretty good. And we can just play the Den Protector as a 2-drop if we want to. Probably won't. It depends on how aggressive our opponent starts out. If he plays a turn 2 Jace, I probably will play it. Well, now we're clearly just playing that instead. It's much better. Okay, no turn 2 Jace yet again. Pretty convenient. We'll go ahead and fetch up our Canopy Vista. Nice. So we're going to get that knight value. Well, probably. I guess our opponent could miss their third land drop, and then we would not get that knight value, but I would be okay with that, too. If he plays a Mantis Rider this turn, I'm trying to think what we would do. I think we'd still just play knight, level up Hangar Back, and pass with the expectation of Dromoka's Commanding or Stasis Snaring the Rider. The other option would be to like Stasis Snare it immediately or level up in Dromoka's Command. Does drawing that land change anything? So the options we have for this turn. Stasis Snare, attack for one. Dromoka's Command, pop the Hangar Back. Or Knight and level and take another three. I think we're pretty well set up to win the long game, actually. So maybe I'll wait on the Knight. We can always play, next turn we can always play knight, fourth land, or really our fifth land, because we'll get a land off the knight unless our opponent misses a land drop, in which case I think they're going to lose anyway. We can go knight, and then morph Den Protector or Stasis Snare. So I think I'm actually going to go with Dromoka's Command this turn. Get our 3/1/1s. Oops. Basically, I think our hand is pretty good. And our opponent Mulligan, so they're a little short on resources. So I would like to try and extend the game, or at least preserve our life total, I guess. Not really extend the game, to give them a chance to get back in it. Yeah, so we got a Radiant Flames out of that deal. That's definitely fine. And now I'll just play Knight. Get our land, which is going to be a Canopy Vista this time. And I think just pass. We'll just Stasis Snare whatever he plays and then have Gideon next turn. Or Den Protector if we need it. I think this should be good. It's possible I could have just played Gideon this turn, but that's really weak if he plays Sarkhan. Which we don't know yet if he does or not. The Pantheon deck had one. So could definitely be a possibility. He's just doing nothing. So probably dig through time or maybe just stuck on a bunch of removal. Either way, Knight is getting in there. And I think, yeah, I guess there's no good reason to not play Hangar Back. There's no reason for us to get the blue mana here. I'm just going to get another Canopy Vista in case we need it somehow down the road. The great thing about Gideon is he does not get Ojutai's Commanded. He does get negated. Okay, well, that happens. And then we get our Hangar Back. So that's fine. We still have a decent amount of pressure and, you know, good cards in our hand. It looks like he's going to dig, so we're probably a little bit behind now. Maybe I was too quick to snap off his Mantis Rider. More Mantises. So if we draw a land, we can, well, we could use Den Protector to get back Dromoka's Command and fight the Mantis Rider. I don't think that's the best use of our resources, though. I think it's better to Stasis Snare the Mantis Rider and attack. And level up Hangar Back. We could also play Den Protector, but that plays right into Radiant Flames, although a second one feels a little unlikely. But given that we have enough mana to play Den Protector, return Dromoka's Command, and cast it all in one turn, I think that's my preference to just leave that option on the table and not expose our Den Protector right now. This does play into Ojutai's command a little bit, but we are already on board, so our opponent would probably have to react in some way. Like, they're probably not going to just be able to leave up Ojutai's command very easily. Maybe he will if he just has Jace. Although, like, yeah, the Jace is actually not all that threatening. We're attacking pretty hard, and he doesn't have a lot of cards in his graveyard, so... And there's another hanger back. So I think I want to start with the hanger back. I'm just going to play it for a 1 to try and bait Ojutai's command. Okay, so now I think he probably doesn't have it, because I think he would have to cast it if he did. Yeah, I guess I was wrong. Yeah, that's definitely bad for us. We're definitely on the back foot now. Although, again, like I said, we're way ahead on board, so there's a chance we can just end the game quickly here. Could also draw any of our big cards like Nissa or anything like that. It's going to be a Tasigur, it looks like. So that is somewhat annoying, especially given that he has enough mana to activate it right now. Another Den Protector is certainly good. Let's see if we can make that work. Nice. So we can try and kill Jace, but now his Jace is again not in any, you know, in any shape to flip anytime soon. So I think I'm just going to pass. He can't really attack with Tasigur very well into our board, and we can rebuy Gideon and maybe Emblem it, which would be pretty nice. We can just charge our 2 hanger backs this turn. Okay, he got back an Utter End. That's pretty annoying. It's also kind of annoying that it doesn't show it, but whatever. I have to just scroll into the chat to look. He's just utter-ending Stasis Snare right now. That's interesting. I'll definitely let that resolve, because there's nothing I can do about it. And then let's see if he wants to attack. I think what I want to do here is unmorph Den Protector, get back Dromoka's command, and have this put a counter on this hanger back and have it fight Mantis Rider. I guess I can take 3 first, though, and then we get to level both of our hanger backs. Maybe that's better. Yeah, I think that is better. So I'll just let that happen. Level up both the hanger backs, then rebuy the command. In a low resource game like this, I think making sure that we eke out every bit of value is probably important. We can attack with everything. He doesn't have Crackling Doom up. He might have a removal spell. I'm thinking if we just attack with all of our creatures, he blocks something with Tasigur. And then we put a +1/+1 counter on one of our hanger backs and fight Tasigur. That's like a pretty good line for us. Yeah, I think I'm gonna do that. And then we still have a Death Mist Raptor to follow up with. So it's not like we're completely dead if he has a way to deal with it. I guess I could leave back this hanger back. because it's pretty effective at fighting Tasigur. Because it can grow to survive, whatchamacallit, the 3-point, 1 mana, 3 damage creature to a creature burn spell, Fiery Impulse. Yeah, so that's actually excellent. So what I'm going to do is go charge this hanger back, and then say, put a +1/+1 counter here and have this fight that, or have this one fight that. This is really bad against a Wrath, but I think it's pretty good against almost everything else. Obviously, if he has like Dispel or whatever, it just doesn't matter. But we still get two. We still have some blockers out of the deal. And yeah, now we just have a huge Air Force. In fact, I think our Air Force is so big that there's not a lot of point in playing this Death Mist. I think we're better off holding it. Just in case, because like, I think the only way he gets back into this game is with a Wrath. It's also possible I should have not attacked with the Thopter there. Or with the other hanger back, because leaving one unpopped is pretty nice. But he might just be dead also. I guess he can always flashback Utter End, so. Yeah, looks like we got it. Alright, that was a pretty tight match, pretty close. Which I think this matchup is pretty close. Yeah.